What's up, guys?
My name is Sempai, and today I'm here with
Allison, and we are going to show you how to punch like a girl.
Today, I'm going to show you 5 ways how to not punch like a sissy. First thing is eyes. Make sure you visualize your target. It's very important to keep your eyes focused, going straight through. So you don't want to stop. You want to think like a laser beam all the way. Not only is it important to have your eyes forward, but also strong attention to your target. Start and finish your technique with the breath. The faster you breathe, the faster you move. For example, you touch a hot stove, what's the first thing that goes? It's your breath, not your body. So we want to take that reaction and take it into our breath. It's very easy to breathe incorrectly. So make sure you breathe from your diaphragm, not your throat. You don't want to be here from your throat. You need to be down here. Here are some examples of bad breathing.
The correct way. 3. Stance. Everybody thinks your power comes from your upper body, but in reality it comes from your lower body. To generate power, you need a strong, deep stance that's not too long and not too short. The correct stance needs to be deep but short enough so you're able to move. Long stance is bad because even though you're stable, you have no mobility. While short stance offers a freedom of movement at the expense of stability. Shoulder width apart, knee over toe, with a balance of mobility and stability.
Move forward, hips. Hips are essential because they allow you to hit with your full body weight. For example, 150-pound karateka will be hitting much harder than the average 250-pound male. So the karateka will be hitting with his full body weight, as opposed to an average male who's only hitting with his upper part of his body, mainly his shoulder. Bicep. Most people don't know is that your hips tie both sides of your body together. You punch without your hips, just one side of it. My shoulder, only the right side of my body. With your hips, you want to engage left and the right side. So my front leg is pulling, back leg's pushing, this hand's drawing in. I have maximum body force, maximum power. I'm going to rotate your hips 45 degrees, stop dead center on impact. 5. Technique. What most people don't understand is that the more you clench your fist, the more power is being wasted and being trapped inside your body. In general, the stronger you feel, the weaker you are.
To know how tight you need to have your fist, imagine that you're holding a baby bird. If it's too loose, it'll fly away. If it's too tight, you'll crush it. It'll be right in the middle.
All together. 1. Eyes. 2. Breath. 3 stance, 4 hips, 5 technique.
Three things you want to think about when delivering a technique is that your foot, hand, and breath all land at the same time.
Last thing to remember is you don't want to punch at your target.
You want to punch through your target.
Thanks for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.
And we'll see you next time.
Nice.